posted another video on Beast Quest. This I've already done a series 1 review, and now I'm doing a series 2. So yeah, let's start off with number 7, Zephyr. It's pretty good. Basically in this series, it's called the Golden Armor. And basically Tom is met, he was gonna be given the Golden Armor because he finished his first quest, and then Marvel took all the armor, and each beast has got at least one piece. Zephyr has the helmet, you can see it down there. He's a Zephyr the Monster Squad. Pretty good. Sorry, I'd give it about a probably a 7 out of 10. Yeah. Not the best, but pretty good. And once he's killed, he turns into like tons of different little squids. So yeah, that's him. Next there's Claw, the giant monkey. He's got the chainmail. Zephyr. The helmet is basically it gives Tom keen sight, and you can just see for long distances. The chainmail gives you strength of heart. So and Claw is pretty cool. The only way he could be killed was, well, Tom couldn't kill him in the trees, so he had to get Claw down, and he couldn't really walk good because of his big giant claws. And he's got a big claw at the end of his tail, that's why he's called Claw. Pretty good. I'd give it about a 8. Out of 10, or 7.5. Next, it's Ultra, the Stone Charmer. This is pretty cool. I like this one because it's set in Tom's home village, Erino, and he turns Farmer Gretlin or something to stone, and he's still alive, but he's too cold. Cows aren't. So yeah, I like that. Basically she's called the Stone Charmers because if you looked into her eye, the big giant eye, you'd basically be turned to stone. Tom killed her with his blades, reflecting off the sunlight and her eye, and she just basically died. And she turned into a skeleton. And when Claw was defeated, there was tons of monkeys, and she was just a skeleton. And she had the breastplate, the golden breastplate, which gives them good physical strength. I'd give it about 8.5 out of 10. Next is Vipro, the snake man. I'd say he has the leg armor. Pretty good. He's in the desert and he's looking for water, and he cuts his water bag thing, so it all just seeps into sand, and so they're thirsty, exhausted in this hot desert, and have to kill a beast. First, Tom cuts off his the snake's heads, and then the two heads are still alive, and then the body's dead, and Tom can't kill him until he tricks the heads for to dive at him, and then they get stuck in a cactus. So, and then Apos comes and flames them up, and tons of snakes come out. On that one, Apos helps Tom. On that one, I'm not sure. I think it was Arcta. Let's check. Soltra was Arcta, I think, who helped him. Yeah. Funny, because we've both got one eye. Claw, it was Ferno who helped him. Zephyr was obviously Septrin, because it's in the sea. So, yeah, that's Vipro, Snake Man. I'd give it a 7. Or 7.5 out of 10. Probably a 7. Arachnid was pretty cool. I liked it. Arachnid, the King of Spiders. Start off with... the leg armour gave him extra speed. And this Arachnid had the gunlets, the fist armour, and that gave him better sword skills and stuff. And I think he could punch hard, better grip and stuff. And this one, Nanook helps him, and and tons of spiders go crawling once he's dead. Last, it's Trillion, the three-headed lion. I really like this one, mainly because of the way it's set and stuff, and the beast was just pretty cool. It's cool how they had to trick Trillion to chasing after Storm through the lake and stuff, and that's how they killed him, by he drowned because he ran into the lake, and because lions can't swim because their mane gets soaked up the water and brings them down like an anchor, so they end up drowning. And Trillion didn't turn into lions after he died. He turned into the gateway to Tom's next quest, Dark Realm, which is in Gorgonia or something. That turns into a big gateway with a lion head gateway to Gorgonia and Avantia. He has the golden boots, and that gives Tom like the ability to jump far distances and for great heights. So yeah, I'd give that about probably a 8.5 out of 10. I do have the special bumper edition, but I've not read it. It's Spiris, the bird phone, the phone ghost, I don't know. Ghost Phonics or something like that. And I was gonna start reading it after Trillion, but because of the ending of Trillion leads on to the third series so good, I just started reading Torgor the Minotaur, and yeah, and now I'm on series 4 and still not read them. The only bumper I've read is the first one, Vedra and Crimin, and that was my best, so I'm pretty sure that will be pretty good. And Trillion, he captures who is it? Not Ferno, not Seprin. No. Not Arcta. Must have been Tagus. Tagus helps Tom. Tagus almost dies in it. But Tom uses Epos's talent to heal the wounds and stuff, so he doesn't. But yeah, overall for this series without the bumper, I'd give it a 8.5 out of 10. See, and yeah, that's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. As I said, I've got the special bumper edition, but not got around to reading it yet. So yeah, I'll be making another video on the third series, so tune in and I'll get that. Yeah, bye.